I'm Tobias Platen. I did my master thesis about speech and singing voice synthesis. And this year at FOSCON 2016, I will present some work that I did and that I'm currently doing on singing synthesis. So the first one which had inspired me is the software Vocaloid with their avatar Hatsune Miku. She is actually a virtual singer and she is very popular in Japan, and that is based on Vocaloid, a singing synthesis software. Vocaloid was developed by Yamaha and by the University Pompeu Fabra Music Technology Group. And Vocaloid is sold in a box at a price greater than 80 euros, and it's not easy to get the Hatsune Miku software. And Vocaloid is only licensed to companies that publish voices, and some other companies did not get a license. So there is still no German Vocaloid. And for French, a different singing synthesis technology based on hidden Markov models was chosen. And once you have a license for the software, you need to start, can start recording. And usually you record voices from existing singers, also often from lesser known anime voice actors, and then after recording, the voice data needs to be processed using complex spectral models. And that is done by Vocaloid in the background. And when you want to understand how the spectral models work, then you can read various papers published by Yamaha, the Music Technology Group, and also some other Japanese universities. And Vocaloid also has a graphical editor where one can input melody and lyrics. And earlier singing synthesizers, including Ambrola, lacked such an editor. And before Vocaloid, there was a program called Ambrola, which is also a normal speech synthesizer. It is not designed for singing, but it can be used as a singer with some quite easy hacks. And when you create voice databases, this is now much easier, as you don't need to manually mark voice pulses, as voice is a periodic signal. I can demonstrate this later at the end in the Prat software. No pulse marking is needed, and this improves the voice quality. And both synthesizers, Ambrola and Vocaloid, are concatenation-based. They concatenate segments which have been pre-processed. Normally, this is spectral pre-processing, But in the case of Embrolla, we just remove aperiodicity so that no phase mismatches can occur. And in both cases, the output voice sounds similar to the input voice when no transformation is applied. So the Vocaloid Gakupo sounds similar to GACT. And when you have the English Embrolla voice, there is a festival voice, and both voices sound similar. Their timbre is the same. And both synthesizers are actually capable to synthesize in real time. On Embrolla, this can be done on an old Intel 836. And Vocaloid and similar algorithms require more modern hardware, such as a Quarto Duo. And the Embrolla algorithm, which is unpublished, seems to be a subset of the Vocaloid DSP. So when I work on a Vocaloid clone, I will also create an Embrolla clone, which can be used by other communities, such as Debian Accessibility. This is a screenshot of the Cadenci software, which is free and localized for the Japanese language. It runs on Debian and allows you to control the UTAO components using Vine. But there is also vConnect Stand, which is designed to replace parts of UTAO, and this works only using Cadenci. And UTAO is a fan-made Vocaloid clone, still proprietary software where anyone can record voices. The voice bank format itself is documented, and there is free software which can handle those voice banks. And for voice processing, UTAO uses resamplers which do essentially two things. One of those things is changing the pitch, and the other is changing the length of speech segments. And there are several free resamplers which are based on World, which was at that time released under the GPL. And one of those world-based tools, also that is more than a resampler, is vConnect Stand. There is also a tool called WAVTool, which concatenates those wave files that UTAO creates. That is controlled by the UTAO editor or by Cadenci. When you want to create voices, you can use the softwares Oremo and Zparam. Both are released as free software, but officially only run on Windows. And there is another bug which makes those programs only run on Japanese systems, and there are some workarounds to run them on non-Japanese systems, mostly due to the fact that they use the proprietary Japanese shift-JIS encoding, which is only used on Windows. Later, I discovered a program called eCantorix, which is a singing synthesis front-end. It was originally written in Perl using MIDI Opus and mass.fft, and there are some singing synthesis examples on the internet using that eSpeak frontend. eCantorix also supports some Embrolla voices, And recently there is support for the old Flight Festival speech synthesizer. And later I decided to take that approach and rewrite eCantorix using Wald. That is now called eCantorix 2, eCantorix 2. And there is Qtau, that is my own piano roll editor using Qt. I wrote one version which used an SMS UTAO resampler that I had written in 2011. And now I'm working on an UTAO synth clone which can create a more natural and more and allows you to use existing UTAO voices. And this runs natively on GNU Linux. It does not require any Java or C sharp. And it adds Jack transport. That is a nice feature that is also present in Vocaloid 2. That is similar to Rewire. When you start transport in one program, all other programs begin playback and that is synchronized. Wald by Masanori Morrissey is a vocoder-based speech synthesis. It was used in older UTAO resamplers. And the new version of Wald uses new algorithms, which are both similar to the Japanese invented tandem straight and the well-known Embrolla algorithm. I will cover three of those algorithms. The first one is the fast F0 estimation, so speech signals are periodic and contain an F0. And then if you filter out frequencies other than the F0, so higher frequencies are filtered out, a perfect sinusoid should appear. And this is used as the fundamental frequency. Then using the cheap trick algorithm, the spectral envelope is estimated. It takes one speech pulse at a random phase and then only takes the power spectrum. It doesn't take phase into account and this power spectrum is smoothed using the known fundamental frequency at that point. And finally, aperiodicity is estimated using the group delay function. And with those three parameters, it is possible to synthesize speech and even singing. And it is, you can also convert speech to singing by adding a singer's format. And in the new version of Wald, there is real-time synthesis using ring buffers. And my software, which I demonstrate here, uses these ring buffers. Here I have an overview of Wald, where those three parameters can be transformed, but we can also save and compress those parameters for later use. And there I began using the Sepstrom. I took that idea out of the VConnect stand synthesizer. And first, the wie just selbst drum to remove interferences caused by the periodicity, this is actually done in the cheap trick algorithm. But then in a second pass, we use a Mel Selbstrom again and compress the signal. As we need minimum phase spectra for the synthesis, we also use the Selbstrom to create those minimal phase spectra. And now I'll explain how speech data is compressed and concatenated in one example, which I had tested using an older version of Wald. In uncompressed, there are two large buffers per frame, one containing the whole spectrum and one containing the whole periodicity. And there is a lot of redundancies in this data. So we compress this by building the Mel-Selbstrom and take only the first 32 samples, and we don't need double precision, so it is saved as a float. And this makes the speech data even smaller than the original wave files when the files are recorded in CD quality. So this doesn't work well at lower rates, in this case peaks and other synthesis algorithms would work better, but this one is designed for high-quality singing synthesis. And now I'll explain why we use the group delay in Wald. The FFT phase is wrapped in the plus minus pi interval, which causes some practical problems that when the phase is on the edges, this becomes problematic and it needs to be unwrapped. So before we had the D4C algorithm, a different algorithm called Platinum was used by older versions of Wald, and that used an interpolation of the fundamental phase to get the position of the pulses, but in some times pulses could not be estimated, so one pulse was dropped in the synthesized speech. And Platinum starts on the first voice pulse onset, which is normally the local maximum in the first voice segment, and then everything is propagated to the next pitch period, where a next local maximum should appear. And then you create a residual spectrogram which contains the phase of the input voice. And that is deconvolved with the already known spectrum. And with the new D4C algorithm, we don't have this dependency on the phase. We calculate the aperiodicity for each frequency band, and this is similar to the spectral model synthesis, which was developed at the Music Technology Group, used in early versions of Vocaloid, but this one is wideband and allows a much better control range over the voice source. And now I'll explain how does one record voice, as we have a good voice processing framework. And for UTAO, there is a tool called Oremo, which comes with a list of Japanese recording lists. These are usually based on the Japanese hiragana alphabet, which can be easily recorded for sustained singing. But for speech, you need a full dphone set, and for other language, it is better to work with a full dphone set and insert only sustained vowels if you need singing synthesis. And Embrolla, for example, lacks those synthesized vowels, and therefore it does not produce very good singing results. So I decided to rewrite Oremo for GNU Linux using Jack, and at that time I used Embrolla to play the stimulus, but I found out that I can replace this one with eSpeak even if I do singing synthesis, where the pitch of the synthesized voice needs to be more adjusted, and that wasn't possible with eSpeak at the time. I usually use a condenser microphone with a big membrane and a pop killer, and after recording one phoneme, I calculate the pitch using World, and if everything is okay, it is inserted in the database. If not, I'll have to record this simple phoneme, and that is assisted by the software. But it is also possible to use existing voices of the festival speech synthesis system, which is also known to be able to sing, and it was used in the Czech software Singing Computer. After recording voices, we have to transcribe the voices so that we can use them for singing synthesis. And there are several incompatible ways to label recordings. The first one is just using hiragana and optional gomaji if you are Japanese. And then we have to mark the end and the beginning and the middle of a sang phoneme. And for Japanese, you only change the length of the vowel. The length of the consonant is never changed. By contrast, in singing synthesizers that support much more languages, such as Embrolla and Vocaloid, we use the International Phonetic Alphabet Zampa, and for Japanese Vocaloids, then hiragana gets mapped to the Zampa alphabet. And then we can enter hiragana in an editor that supports Japanese, and this could be even mapped to a German voice. The labeling of the voice data has to be done manually using a graphical sound editor. There is no hidden Markov model-based software that is free and works reliably. In singing synthesis, we have a pre-utterance on each syllable. So when you have a car in singing, the vowel must start on a beat. And that has to be found out and inserted into the label database. And if you concatenate vowels, then you have to specify an overlap value which depends on the current segment type. And then you need to mark segments, whether they are stable or transient, whether they are vowel or consonant, and only the stable parts of a vowel or liquid can be sustained. And in fast singing, nasals can be compressed, so we can mark those things that we want to compress. But in other cases, those nasals can be sustained, so that is very complex. And I don't have general rules how to make that more easy. Here I have an example of such a Japanese Utao voice called Namine Ritsu. And the first one is the K phoneme, which consists of the K vowel and an A. And for the na, it is similar. And in this case, you can see that the N is voiced and that K is unvoiced. And unvoiced segments like K cannot be stretched, so that needs to be marked. And there is silence on the beginning. This silence is needed by the resampler, but it needs to be skipped when doing synthesis. So offset and cutoff are also marked in the auto INI. Now I have decided to replace those things after that I found that world is really high quality. It produces a better quality than Bratz internal pitch shifter. I decided to write the components first and then do the voice recording, or write a component that allows me to use pre-recorded voices. And currently I'm also working on a drop-in replacement for the Embrulla executable. And I also modified eSpeak that I can now export label data and then apply the new algorithms on the eSpeak output. So I can stretch some segments and produce longer vowels. And I have packaged those programs on my not a bug site, where Sekai contains additions that I wrote in the last 2 years. This is one of a recent screenshot of my Qtao editor, which currently can only use eSpeak, but I plan to add Utao and support. And then for other languages, that is English and German, I will have to change the label data format. It's the simplified Utao only supports Japanese or other languages that have lesser consonants, that is Finnish. It doesn't work well for English and German. And now you have an example of eSpeak pronouncing the name of one of those Vocaloid characters. And eSpeak puts out those labels to the speech. And before that patch, it was impossible to do singing synthesis with eSpeak. And now I will demonstrate some Embrola, VConnect Stand and other, but not Vocaloid singing synthesis examples. And this one is the license patch, which I'll skip. And here I have some examples, including one Swedish song of Embrola that was done some years before Vocaloid.
Att du älskar mig. Bara det blir sommar får jag svar, kära lilla du. Det då ska jag spörja.
And I also changed the eSpeak to be able to sing. Here I have one example. So this doesn't sound as natural because this is Formansynthesis. Now the synthesizer runs and creates those compressed files, which is only done once. So when you run again, it will be much faster. And when all files are created, the synthesis will start. And other programs will also start playback. Yes. Here now it creates the various compressed files which are used for synthesis. And once the files are created, it starts playback. Here I have some empty measures. And
So
this can be improved in quality by using a pre-recorded speech samples of a real human. As eSpeak has only a 300 kilobyte speech voice bank, which is shared among many languages. And now I'll present some WAV files, which I load into Audacity. Yes, when I'm done. So here I have four different waveforms. And now I'll play the first. That is not a problem. I nearly finished. I finished the presentation. Now I show the results.
Kiyoshi, kono yoru.
The first one is a sample by Hatsune Miku, the Vocaloid character, which I showed first, and no processing was applied. Now I used Prat to pitch shift this, and Prat is not designed for music, and it will produce a lesser sound quality.
Kiyoshi. Kono yoru miku wa inoru minna to issho ni utsukushii uta o.
And additionally, Prat does not allow to convert a female voice into a male voice, and that can be done with World, but I first show a normal pitch shifted version.
Kiyoshi. Kono yoru miku.
And in this case, there are no artifacts which are caused by phase mismatches from the TD-PSOLA algorithm. And we can also spectrally scale the voice and create a much deeper male voice. And in Vocaloid terms, this is known as the fan-made Hatsune Miku-o.
Kiyoshi, kono yoru, miku wa inoru.
So I obtained the last one using World and specifying effector to change the timbre, but I also transposed everything one octave down so that it can be sung by a male voice. And here I have an example of Namine Ritsu, which is also based on a world-based synthesizer. And this one Archives a much better sound quality than the original Imbrola synthesizer, which is only for speech and then used for singing. And in the case of Imbrola, we support much more languages, such as Swedish. There are virtually no Japanese songs for Imbrola. And now I'm at the end, and I'll give you the possibility to ask.
Thanks, Tobias, for your very intensive and in-depth presentation. And I think we have time for two or three questions, if there are any. Any questions from the audience? Please hold on so I can pass you the mic.
Can you please play all four voices together?
Yes.
As chorus?
Yoshi, kono yoru,
okay, any more questions? So you're working basically on... Oh, I'm sorry. So you're working basically on Japanese songs at the moment, if I understood.
Mostly, yes, as most voices are support only Japanese, but I want to support much more languages than Japanese.
So what are the necessary steps to, say, support English or German as well as a language?
Much harder, it's more work is needed to...
So, are you looking for more developers supporting your work, or is it more a technical challenge that needs to be addressed?
That is a technical challenge, as I have a nearly complete software, but I didn't have time to record voices now, and so when I have time, I'll improve the things.
Okay, and is there an open source community working on these issues? Do you have a website or something?
But the community is only small. Mm-hmm. And for me, I couldn't do all everything. I had to rely on existing community works. The community of the voice providers is big, but the developer community is low. So Utah has a big user and community, and users can record their voices, but most users of Utah are not programmers. And those who are programmers often write software, and sometimes they release the software as free software. But in other cases, the software which can be very popular is non-free. That is a well-known problem at beginning with Imbrola. That one is non-free, and it seemed that nobody in the Debian community knew how to create a free replacement for that Imbrola synthesizer. So there is a big community, the Debian accessibility community, for example, works on a Braille music compiler, And I'm using the music XML library of Mario Lang, which he uses in his Braille music compiler. I've decided to use the same library so I don't have to write my own.
Okay, so thank you very much. Do you have a slide with some contact information so people who may watch the video can contact you or something?
I created a homepage and I'll soon publish an email address.
Okay.
I now go to the slide where I have not a bug site, that is this one. Where I can be contacted. So Isengara is my nickname on the internet and as a Vocaloid or Utau producer. And here I have a homepage called ecantorix.moi, which I created, but I didn't publish yet an email address or a contact field, but I will create such one.
Okay, excellent. Again, thanks again, and give a final hand of applause to Tobias, please.